नहीं
हाँ, आर यू एबल टू सी मी?
आई एम नॉट. यू नीड टू क्लिक ऑन द कैम राइट अप.
टर्न स्क्रीन शेयर ऑन. नो. ओके, टर्न वीडियो ऑन.
Yes, I can see you now. Yes.
Okay. Good.
Okay.
So
we need to.
Do we need to wait? Wait.
No, Vineet is there already. I just need to check the participants. How shall I allow? So can shall we start? Hello. Yes, shall we start now? Okay. Come on, Stuti, start now.
Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, we thank you for taking time to attend this session. Me, Stuti Dang, and my co-presenter, Kirti Gumbher, would like to thank you, Vineet sir, for giving us the opportunity to study and represent the Voltas journey. We will be deep dive into this company, Voltas, in the various perspectives, like from the company background and from the shareholding, the moat of the company, and the segmental and the Indian market overview. And then we will finally talk about the financials of the company. Yeah. So to take you through the corporate background, Voltas is a Tata Group company, and it is the India's largest air conditioning company, which was launched in 1954. Voltas generally focused on to derive value from smart engineering, and it has the operation that are classified under three major business segments, which are unitary products, engineering projects, and engineering products and services. Voltas distribution network covers around 15,000 touch points in India. Now we will take at the leadership team. The leadership team of the Voltas or the Tata Group companies is fairly a very good ethical company and has a very good management team. So in the leadership team, we have Niall N. Tata, who is the chairman of Tata Group company. The Pradeep Bakshi is the managing director and CEO of Voltas. Anil George, deputy managing director of Voltas. Narendra Nair, chief human resource officer. Abhijit Gajendra Gadkar, chief financial officer. And Dinesh Singh, chief strategy officer.
So I'll talk about the pillars of this company. So they basically have five pillars. First is their smart thinking. They have a winning attitude because that's why they're number one in the market. They're quite innovative. They love experiencing new things and new technologies. They are flexible and they have a great team to work on with. I'll be talking about the locations that they have. They have their headquarters in Mumbai, and then they have the zonal headquarters in Delhi, Kolkata, and Chennai. They are located in GCC in Asia, basically in UAE, Dubai, Muscat, Bahrain, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and Singapore. This location is quite strategic because a lot of their electromechanical projects are based in this country. At the same time, they have their exports coming across to these countries. They have very strategic locations when it comes to their factories as well. They have their factories in Thane, Dadra, Pannagar, Vagodia. And there are two upcoming plants. One is in Tirupati, another one is Sananath. There's a reason why these plants are being established. Tirupati is basically is there to actually cater the southern market, and Sananath is for the white goods because they recently entered into a JV with Beko, where they'll be focusing on getting the refrigerators, washing machines, and microwaves business. So for that particular JV, they have set up this plant in Sananath. This is an important site. This actually tells the moat of the company. Voltas is India's number one brand in air conditioners, which is, I mean, they have more than 24% of the market share in the RAC. And this is surely due to various reasons. One of them is the high brand recall, because of course it's a Tata Group company, so it has a very good brand value. After sales services are tremendous. Customers are very happy because they believe in customer loyalty and they keep their promises. They have a wide distribution network, as Stuti told, like 15,000 distribution network across the country they have. They offer good margins to the dealers, so they are the preferred brand for the dealers as well, and they pitch Voltas massively and aggressively, and they have high range of products.
So now we will take you through the shareholding pattern of the Voltas company. We have we can see that it has the promoter with highest holding as 30.3%, and its mutual fund holding is also high, which is 27.64%. And there is no pledging of shares from the promoter side. And also we can see that the highest public shareholder is the Life Insurance Corporation of India with 4.56%. So we can, after looking into this, all these points, we can say that the Voltas is the most trusted company for the investors in this particular segment area. Next. Okay. Now we will take you through the cycle of cooling industry. The revenue distribution for the cooling industry is basically in the two quarters, which is Q1 and Q4, with the 30% to 35%. And we can say, looking into this, that the cooling industry main revenue is heavily dependent on Q1 and Q4 instead of Q2 and Q3, which is just 15% to 20%. Now we will take you through the brand journey of the Voltas company. From FY03 to 17, they have set up a new facilities, and they have introduced lots of models, and they have come into the they have launched the inverter models, and their AC sales also has crossed 1 million mark in 2017, and in the FY18 and 19, they have set up with the Voltas Home Appliances Private Limited, and in which they have launched a wide range of white goods products under the Voltas Deco brand. Now, in this particular year, the company has increased the market share to 23.7% in room ACs, and they are, next one. Now we will have a look at the industry analysis. The industry RAC market size is projected to grow at CAGR of 13.3% during 2019 to 2050, and hence the room AC market is highly competitive. And we can see that the market, Indian market, is penetrated only 7 to 8% if we compared with developed nation, which are above 90%. The growing disposable income means the consumer spending is likely to grow from US 1.5 trillion today to nearly US 5 trillion by 2030. Now they have the ongoing and the development phase in the rural electrification, which will be for the tier 2 and tier 3 cities, and then they can expand their business over there as well. From the digital perspective, by 2030 they are expecting that over 1 billion citizens from semi-urban and rural areas are expected to have access to the internet, which will give a huge boost to the consumption. As we have seen, that the northern region has captured major share in the RAC market in India on account of improving residential sector, followed by the southern and western region. Now we would like to have a key highlights on AC industries, in which now the ACs, the RAC segments, is coming under the essential products. As you can see, the Kerala government has declared that AC are the essential products, and AC Association and other bodies of Gujarat have started approaching the state government, and they have signed around 70,000 petition for the same. They have their expansion plan, in which they are considering to set up a new manufacturing plant in southern area for AC and commercial refrigeration segment to boost the growth of Voltas in that particular region.
Okay, now continuing to what my colleague just said, we strongly believe that the RAC market has a strong potential in coming years, and we have done around four studies approximately to prove the fact. So if you look at this this graph, in 1995, the China AC penetration was 4.5%, vis-a-vis the Indian penetration at that time was also 4 to 5%. But China grown from 1995 to 2008, the AC penetration went up from 4 to 5% up till 100%. It took nearly 15 years by China to move this graph to the upward direction. Looking at the current infrastructural developments and the growth of the economy, we expect that in India, which is currently having this segment is around 6 to 7%, we expect it to reach to 100% in coming 7 to 10 years. This is what we expect, and we strongly believe that the infrastructure would let this happen. There was another study that we did. If you look at this side, this CDD means cooling degree days. Higher the cooling degree days, warmer the region is. If you look at it, in China, the cooling days are around 500, but the penetration is around 80 to 90%. It is the household penetration. Vis-a-vis India, if you look at the degree days, it is around 2500, but the penetration is around 6 to 7%. So this again gives us another reason to believe that this industry will certainly improve in the coming 4, 5 to 6 years. The third study that we did was, like, if you look at this graph, the penetration of the consumer durable in India, the highest is the television and lowest is the air conditioner. So in this case, if you look at this graph shows that there's quite a immense room for air ACs to move forward. Another reason that we thought was because of the rural electrification and all, and digital channels and all, maybe the rural crowd will also get the benefit of, because of the rural electrification, we expect this industry to get a boom. The second important part that I want to highlight here, with the JV that Stuti has just mentioned about Beko, they will be focusing on refrigerator and washing machines, which eventually tells us that this also has a room to grow a lot. Fourth study that we did was the electricity, AC electricity consumption. Currently, if the Indian household has an AC in his house, the room AC electricity bills are around 51%. And that's the basic reason why a lot of Indians don't prefer to have ACs in their houses. To cut down this, company has a lot of plans. So they are planning to have the inverter ACs, more innovation into it. I know inverter ACs are still in the market, but they are innovating more so that the electricity consumption can goes down. And second thing that the company is focusing on, the solar ACs. So they have a plan to have solar ACs. So this consumption percentage will go down, and eventually it becomes easier for every household to install it.
Yeah. Now we will talk about the segment details of the Voltas company. The Voltas company has divided into three segments. First is the unitary products, which include ACs, air coolers, and commercial refrigerators. Second is the engineering projects, which has the domestic and as well as international market. And third, we have the engineering products and services, which are into the textile and in the mining companies. Now we will talk about the unitary cooling products. The unitary cooling products has the major share in this particular company, which is more than the revenue is more than 50% for this particular segment. So if we look at the outlook and opportunities for this particular segment, so the going forward demand for air conditioners will be driven by the who look for the exclusive additional features, and also at the same time, that the rising temperatures, increasing disposable incomes, and aspirational levels, it is said that the strong rural demand is anticipated through this. Now, the threats in this particular segment is that is increasing on the basis of uncertainty on currency, duties, and commodity prices, and which will result in the lower margins. However, the company, as the threats they have already given, but they are also focusing to mitigate these threats by improving on value engineering, cost innovation, customer service, and logistics, which will in turn help Voltas to sustain its market dominance. Now we will have the look on the online RSA key brands and SKU. As in the chart, you can see that we have the, first of all, we have the total number of highest number of model with Voltas, which has having the 52 models. And in the and after that, we have Blue Star, which is the 43 models, which we, both of these has the high number of models in their perspective. And now we can see in the models, the split section has the highest number of models, which is 42 Voltas, and for Windows, it is 10.
So I'll be taking next about Voltpec. This is actually a JV, a 50-50% JV that happened between Voltas Limited and Beko. And they launched very recently in September 2018, they launched their products. So the whole objective of this particular JV is to cater the market of refrigerators, to cater the market of washing machines and microwaves. So they know that the currently 70 to 80% market share is with the LG, Samsung, Whirlpool and Panasonic. So Voltas and Beko aims to create or have 10% of the market share by 2024. The strategy to do so is that they will be targeting tier 2 and tier 3 cities. At the same time, they will be lowering 3 to 5% of the prices than that of MNC. With this prospect, they are actually focusing on the Indian mindsets and Indian households. So they launched their product with the name of Made for India features, which includes 30-day storage fresh for the refrigerators and 26 sustain remover for the washing machine. From 2018 until 2020, they have already catered 2% of the shares in the market. So I personally feel that 10% market share by 2024 is not a big deal for them. Engineering product. Like my colleague Stuti said, that this company has three segments. One segment she has already covered. The next two segments I'll be covering. The second segment is engineering projects actually. This is actually electromechanical projects that they take both domestically and internationally as well. Most of the projects there are being funded by the government. So they basically enter into the infrastructural projects taken by the government that relates to water and rural electrifications and all. But the threats are near to this particular segment is that because there's a weak private investment and because of the COVID, the projects can get delayed, the receivables can get a hit. And since the government might postpone or might, you know, postpone their infrastructure projects and priorities might be a shift, because of which this segment might take a hit. The other core of this particular core impact that could come to this particular segment is through commodity prices, because a lot of commodity prices like copper, steel, import duties impact this particular segment. So these are the threats for this. And internationally, in international market, the basic markets that they cover is GCC, which again is going through a political upheaval. And there were two major events that were planned in Middle East, one in Dubai, the Dubai Expo 2020, which is for which Dubai has invested like massively. But because of the COVID, it got postponed to next year. And the second important event was happening in Qatar for FIFA. It was a football, you know, world football. And because of the COVID and because of the bans, the tourism and all, this might take a hit. So we are expecting that 2021, the receivables, the project completion and all might shrink their balance sheets in this case. Third, this is a very interesting kind of a segment. I was surprised when I was doing this research that the revenue share of this particular investment is only 4 to 5%, but the margin is super high, like 30%, 40%. So this actually an eye catcher for me. Basically, this segment, it's called engineering products and services. So they actually supply the products and services to textiles, to mining, and to construction industries. Now, what happens is because there's a Indian government is trying to pull up the textile industry, but still, you know, we are not excelled in that, and we are still striving to move for a growth there. Similarly for mining, and that's why this particular segment has not appealed like properly. But we expect once the government you know, go back and, you know, try to boost the textile industry and mining industry, this segment might take a strong benefit.
Okay, so now as we I the my colleague has explained the rest of the segments, now I will be talking about the risk and the mitigation action the company has taken in the company, like the highly increasing competition. So for that one, they are maintaining and strengthening dealer relationship with the targeting and marketing the advertising campaign. So they are actually maintaining and strengthening in all these particular areas, and also they are steadfast focus on customer service to promote brand loyalty. Now, if we take upon the high tariff risk on the imports, which have actually affected or may have affected the profitability, so now the what Voltas is considering to mitigate this particular risk, that they are driving the Make in India through the upcoming manufacturing facilities in Gutta, and also they are targeting local vendor development to reduce our dependence on imports. Next, if we talk about the risk in the economic headwinds in India, which can affect the growth plans in the short term. So the Voltas has taken the action, mitigation action, that the USP of being present in both the drivers of Indian economy, vis-a-vis the infrastructure sector and consumption sector, will mitigate this risk to a certain extent. And also in the Middle East, they have as a natural hedge against factors which are adversely affect the Indian economy, such as fluctuations. So they have the presence over there, in which they are actually considering the natural hedging. And the last one is the adverse movement in commodity prices may impact profitability. So they are actually establishing adequate commodity risk management framework and hedging policies to mitigate the risk in this one. Now we will have a quick overview on the con call highlights. So first we will take the UCP segment. In this one, the company has said that they have a 60 days of inventory with the dealers, and at the manufacturing levels, the inventory is 90 days. On the installation side, company is not impacted by the migrant laborer, as the generally all the installations and all the other stuffs are done by locals rather than the migrant. Also, after that, which company has the leader of the company, which we have already explained in the mode, it is that the market share the company is enjoying it at the 24.2%. And also they are actually expanding significantly in the tier 2 and tier 3 regions for the RAC sales. And the company has 60% of its sales from tier 2 and tier 3 cities. And in tier 1 and metro cities, it sees 60% of sales going into the replacement demand. And the RAC sales, which is the good one after the opening of the market, they have seen that the e-commerce sales of the RAC are in the RAC particular segment, the house room AC segment, is total of 8 to 10%. Now if we talk about the EMP segment, that due to the sudden lockdown, company expects a delays in execution. And also in the few of its MEP projects, company requires high number of migrant workers. So they are expecting that it will get stabilized in around next 2 to 3 months. And also the main good point is that the most of its domestic projects are government projects. However, in this one, they are not expecting any payment related issues. So might be they can get the payment ASAP in all these projects. Now, if we talk about the other, which is the Volt Tobacco segment, which my colleague has also talked about. In the con call highlights, I would say that the Volt Tobacco is gradually improving its market share, which we have already said that it has already captured the 2% in frost-free refrigerator and washing machine. Now, after we're doing our research, we have found that there are most of the impact on business through COVID. So we will just highlight the few points over here, that due to the extended lockdown and normal monsoon, the business season for RAC has completely whitewashed, and the margin correction in UCP segment across companies has anticipated volume decline in FY21 and discounts and dealer support provided by the brands. Now also, we have already said that delays in execution of ongoing projects and incremental order will on the ha it will have an effect on CapEx activity, and it would take a time to revive. Middle East E&P market is expected to remain weak given weak crude oil prices. And taking all these points into the consideration, and whatever the price correction has the Voltas company share price got, we can say that it's provide an attractive entry point on long-term business prospects.
Now coming back to the financial is our favorite part. So whatever me and my colleague have just discussed, based on that, we have had certain assumptions. Definitely because of the COVID, the financials will take a hit. The other thing or the other factors that we assume is their EMP, which is actually internationally, they have electromechanical projects. They might take a hit because of the postponement of the two major events. And so in 2020, the EBITDA margin was 10.3, which will come down to 6 as per our forecast. Further, we expect it to stabilize at 6.8, and then we cap it to cap between 7 to 8%. The reason why we cap it to 7 to 8%, A, we have taken a very conservative approach because gradually we'll approach towards the valuation of the share. Secondly, what we assume is because this market has immense growth opportunities, that actually brings us back to have more competitors in the market. So they might have Chinese competitors coming in, which might ruin the market. They might ruin the margins. So that's why maybe the volume might increase, and that will certainly increase, but we expect the drop in the margin. So these are the basic assumptions that we took while projecting our revenues. Because the EBITDA margin went down, our EBIT has to go down. So it went down from 9.9 to 5.5%. I want to highlight one point. If you look at the revenue, in 2018, there was a good EBITDA margin of 10.2, but it went down to 8.4. There was a reason behind it. So our study said that in 1918, 19, and 1920, the upgradation of energy efficiency parameters that was laid by Government of India actually made them increase their prices by 4 to 6%. There are other factors that contribute to the cost of goods sold of this particular company. The commodities that are involved in this company is steel and copper, and of course the import prices, because right now currently a lot of AC compressors are being imported from China, because of which the Government of India has been imposing and continuously increasing the custom duty and import duty on that. That's the reason there was a rise in the price. But like my colleague said, they're trying to have the local presence here and try to manufacture all these parts in India. And I expect the prices to go high rather than going down, but dependency on the imports will definitely reduce. We worked on the segment data also. Like we said, this company has three main segments. So I want to highlight that this segment, UCP and EMP, is their bread and butter. Engineering products is definitely a good segment. As I told you, the margins are quite high, but the share is less. It might take a setback of minus 23. So there must be a degrowth of minus 23 on quarter-to-quarter growth charts. So we expect the quarter one to go down by from 9 to minus 23%. And accordingly, quarter two and quarter three might increase because the strategy of the company, the JV that they have entered with Beko, claims that they have a cycle of the entire year, because washing machine and refrigerator and microwaves, they doesn't need any summers and winters for that. So it's an year-long activity. So we expect this number to rise a bit. And then, of course, minus 10% in the last quarter, because the consumption, the demand will not come back to the country that soon because of the COVID. Demand certainly will take time to come back. This is what we expect and we assume, and that's why our revenues are based accordingly. Now, I'm gonna give you a small analysis here. So it's a revenue chart, pie chart, which says that the total revenue that has been earned by the company, UCP, that is their cooling products, their ACs and their air coolers and all, is around 54%. Their electromechanical projects that they undertake with the government, their infrastructure projects and their Middle East GCC country projects, that is nearly 42%, and their engineering products and services, which they were giving to mining and textile industries, is only 4%. But again, an eye catcher here, that the total margin that they earn, 20 total margin on the particular product. So if I talk about UCP, the margin on the UCP is 26%, EMP is 11%, but the engineering projects, which is actually only 4%, has a margin of 63%, which is huge. So I believe if the company works on this engineering products and services and the government supports textile industries and mining, this can blow the rocket. This is what I feel. Okay, now talking about the financials. I hope the financials are looking okay. Stuti, is it looking okay?
Yeah, I'm going to read it.
Okay, so what we expect is that from financial year to financial year 21, we expect a degrowth of 13.2%, which again will come back to 9% and then 10.5% and 10%, and respectively, we expect it to move by 8 to 9%, 9 to 10% yearly after that. This is purely based on the assumptions that I have discussed earlier when we started off financials. There are a few things that I wanted to take you through. This is all what we have just discussed. Based on that, all the financials are being made, which we're going to share with you all a little later. There are a few things that I want to highlight, that this company is a cash-rich company. And second important aspect that we realize that it is a debt-free company, almost negligible debt, which is a good part, and that actually attracts us to invest in this company. Their ROC is quite decent, and we, like I told you, it's a very highly conservative financials that we have worked on, so we expect the ROCs to be pretty decent to two digits, like 11%, 12%, this is what we expect. Okay, so its PE currently is 29.3, which is quite compatible to its peers. PB is 4.3, EV by EBITDA is 22.3, which actually improved from the last year. But this year, due to COVID, it has increased and gradually it will settle down by 25-26. Now our SOTP valuation. This is basically a valuation that we did based on the segments that we have. So it's a segment SOTP valuation. So if you look at this, based on this calculation, our share price, that should be ideally, it's an intrinsic value right now on basis of the segmental revenue, it should be 574. Currently it is trading around 550, which is actually near to its intrinsic value. Similarly, we got the same number, almost near 597 from DSF method, DCF method, sorry. It's a DCF method, 597 value per share, which is again near to what it is, what we actually calculated in the SOTP, like it's 4574 and this one is only 597. And we expect that it is quite trading nicely on its intrinsic value and it would be a good buy right now.
So now, as explained the financials by my colleague, so now we will look at the one-year forward PV chart of the Voltas, in which the red line shows that the lowest point, that is the with the 3.4x, and the orange line shows with the highest, that is 6.83. So now I have put the shares price of against that one. That is, for the 3.4x we have put the 426, and for against the 6.83 we have put the 839, and the middle line which we have is the 5.15, which is the purple line, and the share price which we have taken is the 633. So now if we see that in October or in Jan 2017, the Voltas price was hovering around the lowest one. And after that, in 2018, something, it was hovering around the orange one. So if we say that hovering around the red line, it can be seen that it has it's into its lowest, with the lowest price, and into the orange, it has the highest price. So now if we see for the 1st April 2020, the current price is hovering around the undervaluation of this particular stock price. So similarly, if we compare this the Volcker stock with the Sensex as the stock performance, we can see that it was the growth for the Sensex and the Volcker's growth price was the same from 2000 1st April 2010 to 1st April 2017, and after that it actually overperformed the Sensex in 1st April 2018, and after that it's going side by side with the Sensex. Now we will have the look at some of its the analysis of the peers, in which we have considered the EV by EBITDA as a ratio and the ROCE. So here we can see the Volcker's ROCE is around between the 15 to 20%, or we can say around the 16 to 17%, and the EV by EBITDA is the from 20 to 25%. So if we compare this with Blue Star or Ambit, the EV by EBITDA for Ambit is in the around 10 to 15, and for Blue Star is 15 to 20, which we say that it's maintaining its good value.
Okay, so actually, Blue Star is the close competitor of Volcker's. So, Volcker's has a market share of 24.2%, vis-a-vis Blue Star has a market share of 12.5%. Both these companies have the two basic segments, the cooling segment and the electromechanical segment. So, we tried to analyze the difference between the peers. So, if you look at it, the growth is 5% and it went to minus 2% in Volcker's revenue, and then it rose to 29%, and there's a drop of 18% that we expect in the revenue this year. Vis-a-vis Blue Star, we expect a drop of 26% this year, looking at the various financials. I want to highlight one thing here. Volcker's is the market leader for its UCP products. That means its ACs, coolers, and etc. Blue Star is the market leader in the EMP projects. So he takes the massive projects internationally and domestically, and that's the USP of Blue Star. But these two are quite competitive because one oversees the others. So one is strong with the retailers, the other one is strong with the corporates. But we expect the drop in Blue Star to be minus 26%. Similarly, the margin will go down from 13% to minus 20%, and UCP we expect 7.1% to 5% drop. Again, EMP, which is the bread and butter of Blue Star, we expect it flat. Both the companies might expect a drop of minus 8%. And from 5%, it will get down to minus 40% in that case. Sorry, this is not a bit clear for me. Can I increase the size of this anyhow? Stuti, can you increase the size for me for this?
I'll try, Kirti.
Okay. EMP margins of Blue Star will go down from 4.3 to 4. I cannot see the Volcker's EMP margin going down. This is what is
EMP margin going down for the FY20 for the FY21 to minus 49%.
Minus 49%. Okay. Yeah. And so since, like I told you, EMP is a strong part of Blue Star and for Volcker's UCP. So we expect that kind of a drop in this segment for Volcker's and this segment for Blue Star. Finally, before we take the questions, I would like to conclude that for us, based on the research and the sectoral research and the industry analysis, we feel it's a good buy. And it's a good buy as of now because it's trading as intrinsic value and has a room to grow. So that's why we would recommend to buy the stock. And that's all. Thank you so much. Please, if you have any questions, we are open for that. There's a chat here. Okay. We need to. So, what is SOTP? SOTP is actually SOTP is analysis that we do based on the segmental revenues. So, there is a multiple that has been industry that the industry prescribes, and we multiply the various segment EPS along with it, and we calculate what could be the intrinsic value of this particular stock. What is this? Okay. I think we are done. What is the stock code for Volcker's? We'll check the stock code and let you know. Any other message? Okay. CDD is cooling degree days. And can Voltas not get imports from any other place? Are we not reliant on China? Vishwanathan, yes, we are definitely reliant on China. And that's why to reduce the dependency, the company is trying to opening up the plans and entering into the JVs with other companies. For can Voltas and Mobike cannot get imports from any other place? Coming back to the prices, like I said, even if they reduce the dependency, we expect the price to be high in India. China, the prices are dirt cheap, and that's why they've been a good source of importing rather than any other country in the world. Dependent at this moment, Omega reduce the dependence testing question. I think what they mean is to say monsoon gets prolonged and temperature goes higher at this phase that can end even the monsoon is. Is the IMD has spoke at normal monsoon? Yes, Nachiket, the monsoon is pretty normal, but since we have already lost the month of April and May, we expect the sales to go down. But to compensate a bit, Volt Beko is coming in with the refrigerators, with the washing machines and microwave, which might give them a push in their revenues. What is the growth, sales growth in percentage? So sales growth in sales for which year, Santosh, can you please mention? I cannot get normal monsoon has reduced. Santosh, if you can mention which year growth sales you want, then I can probably work on it. Where there be combo offers for AC refrigerant? Will there, Vishwanathan? I think you are a good marketing guy. Of course, they should have combo offers for AC refrigerator and washing machines. Okay. For recording, will be available. Yes, the recordings will be available. We should stick with Voltas. People need a good market presence. I agree. No need to launch a new brand. They're not launched. I don't think I have any other questions than this. What is the customer feedback on Voltas products? See, it's too early to say, but we are, since they have already captured 2% of the share, we expect it to go because Tata is ethical as well as they have quality products, be it their cars and anything. They never compromise on quality, so we expect Voltas to perform well. By the way, this Beko company is an expert in refrigeration when it comes to frost free. So they are carrying their expertise when they're coming to the country. So they are one of the best in the segment. Murli Krishna, most of the houses in rural are being Bimaru Seth and Pakka. Yes, Nachiket, you are right. Most of the houses are in the rural Bimaru states are Pakka, but we are talking about rural electrification and we are talking about 6 to 9 or 10 years down the line. So I expect it to increase. I think we are done with the questions. Thank you so much. Can we have the polls, please? Let me just call Vineet because I don't think he's. Can you call him, Stuti? Can we?
Yeah, we can. I can call him.
Avinash Singh says that why depreciation is so low. Depreciation is not low. I don't know. It's 5% of the gross block. It's not 0.5. It's 5% of not the sales, but the gross block. So which is quite decent and we are following the trends for the company. Murli, let me just check the poll first because this is the first time I'm taking up this. So what's your question? Okay, so I've active. I have actually put in the okay. The poll is there. Thank you so much, guys, for listening.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you, Kirti.
And thank you for the poll. Thanks, Stuti. And thank you so much.